Welcome to how to tie and fish the zebra midge pattern. The zebra midge pattern is a good all-year pattern that you can use in both moving water and still water. To tie this pattern, you're going to need a couple things. I'm using Daiichi style 1150 size 10 hooks, 210 denier black thread, medium thickness silver wire, and an eighth of an inch silver bead. Let's get to the vise.
Here we are at the vise. I've already have the hook mounted in the vise. I've already put my eighth of an inch silver bead on the hook, and you can't see it, but I actually have got the barb pinched down on this also. I find it a lot easier to get the hook out of the fish's mouth and also get the hook out of my hand if I pinch the barb down. First thing we're going to want to do is we're going to want to dress the hook. And all that is just putting a little bit of black thread across the body of the hook. Cut off the tag end here and then finish tying this down. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take this thread and I'm going to tie it halfway down the middle of the bend in the shank. And then take your medium thickness silver wire and tie it in. How I like to do this is just put it through into the bead and then tie it all the way back to the end of the bead. Now if I wanted to, I could actually stop tying it right here, wrap the silver wire around the body of the fly about 5 to 8 times, and then I could go ahead and tie it off. But what I'm after here is I really want a beefy body on this tie. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to tie the thread back, and then I'm going to stop it just short of where I originally tied. And now I'm going to tie it back to the behind the bead here. And you can see how that really beefs up the body with this 210 denier thread. Now I'm going to take it back. Oops. And then again, just short of where I last ended. Then bring it back to build the body up some more. Behind the head of the bead. Make another turn. Stop short again. And once again, tie short of where I was. Now that's a pretty good body right there. Now the next step, I'm going to take the silver wire and I'm going to wrap it around 5 to 8 times to make it look like this body is segmented. There we have one wrap, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 wraps. Now I'm going to lock it down with 3 wraps. Trim it down. Then push this little end with my fingernail behind the bead. And I'm going to tie it off. Next step, I'm using my whip finisher. And I'm going to tie this thread off. Little tug there to secure it. Finally, I'm going to use a little head cement. I like leaving the thread on and then putting the head cement at the base of the thread before I cut the thread off. Trim it off. Use my thumb. Wipe away the excess glue. And the zebra midge is tied.
Let's talk about how to fish this zebra midge. Here's the zebra midge on the end of my tippet. I like to tie the zebra midge down with a knot called a Duncan loop. What a Duncan loop does is it lets me set a loop about an eighth of an inch above the top of the fly. So when I work the fly, it lets it wiggle around a little bit in the water. There's quite a few videos on YouTube that show these little creatures swimming to the surface. They actually wiggle and squirm their way up to the surface. If you just let it hang there in the water, it's not going to seem very exciting to the trout. So you tie that Duncan loop with that little bit of space up to it. When you wiggle the line and when you pop it, it makes that midge kind of bounce around there just a little bit, adds a little bit of action to it. Another thing I have about a foot and a half above my zebra midge, I've tied a strike indicator. This one is called a thingamabobber, and it's really nice because it sits on there with a half hitch, and you can adjust the depth. One of the things you're looking for when you're out here fishing for these trout is you got to figure out the size of these things they're biting on, the color, the depth, and how far away from the bank these trout really are at. A lot of times you'll be fishing for these trout, and you'll see the bobber just kind of like bouncing around a little bit on the surface. When that happens, what you want to do is you want to take your line and you want to just pop it a little bit. Make the zebra midge bounce around a little bit again. A lot of times it'll induce a strike.
Here's five examples of zebra midges that I recently tied. The two black ones off to the left have silver beads. They're both size 10 hooks. Off to the right of the dime, you'll see two red zebra midges in size 14 hooks. One has a golden bead head, the other has a silver bead head. The one on the left has a skinnier body than the one on the right, has a thicker body. The zebra midge underneath the Roosevelt dime has a gold head, and it's a size 22 hook, and it shows you the versatility you can use in tying these zebra midges. You can tie them just about any size that you need.
Well, there you have it, how to tie and how to fish the zebra midge. It's a really good year-round pattern that you can use anywhere around here in northern Utah. If you don't feel like tying the pattern, there's a lot of really good fly fishing stores around the area. Here in Roy, there's a really good fly fishing store. Due to constraints on the video, I'm not allowed to mention their name, but if you go up to the counter and tell them what you're looking for, they'll be able to help you out. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you around the bank.